soon I will be done with the troubles of this world. Oh, my troubles of this world, troubles of this world. Good afternoon, everybody. This is Brother Lloyd, and to those who are keeping the Sabbath today, Shabbat Shalom. I hope you're having a blessed and peaceful Sabbath day. Now, we're going to spend a few minutes today talking about the serpent, or the encounter with Eve and the serpent in the garden. So, right out the gate, my question is, do you really know the story of our first parents? Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to retell it using the scriptures, as always, but with more of an open and slow perspective so that you can see some things a little differently as I have from going over some of this over and over. Now, as we know, Satan was kicked out of heaven with one third of the hosts of heaven that sided with him. If we go to Revelation 12:4, it reads, it says, "And his tail drew the third part of the stars of heaven and cast them to the earth." Now, we have understand this. Stars in Revelations, in this passage, represents angels. And we know that the first part where it says, "And his tail drew," the tail, which is the tail of the dragon, Satan, that means that Satan brought, or basically coerced, one third of the stars or angels of heaven to side with him. So when he was cast out of heaven, one third of the host fell with him. This is where all the fallen angels come from, and that is the number that fell. We don't know the exact number. We know that part, the third part. So anyway, that's another study. Been there, done that one before. Now, we know this happened after the creation and before the temptation of Eve. Now, before in a previous video, I stated that Satan had no access to heaven and earth, and that's true to a point. So I'm going to clarify it by saying this: without permission of the Heavenly Father. Remember, Satan has no power. As we saw in my video last week about Job, if he's allowed or if he's summoned, he does or will, as was stated in Job 1, verses 6 and 7. Go with me there. Verse 6 reads, it reads, "Now on the day when the children of God came and stood before the Lord, Satan came also among them. Then the Lord said unto Satan, Whence comest thou? And Satan answered the Lord, saying, From compassing the earth to and fro, and from walking in it." Now, as I stated last week, if called, he is compelled to do so, as we saw. Obviously, if he's allowed to do something that he feels is going to benefit him, he does it. And what we're going to see shortly is how he was given access to earth. Now, after the creation, including Adam and Eve, we must understand a few things. Adam and Eve communed with the Father and with the angels, as illustrated in Scripture. But like us, they were also given free will to choose. So now their obedience was tested. See, their obedience had to be tested also. So their obedience was tested by this commandment as given in Genesis 2:17, which reads, it says, But of the tree of knowledge of good and evil, thou shalt not eat of it. For in the day thou eatest thereof, thou shalt die the death. Now, notice that this command was before Eve was created, but yet she knew about it. She was told and warned just like Adam. Whether he told her, whether the Father told her, whether the angels told her, she was warned about it, so she knew about it. And if you follow the story, obviously, during her encounter with the serpent, she expressed her knowledge of this commandment, or this law, that she should not be there and dealing with this tree, but she did it anyway. Now, the main focus in this story is to show you a few things about the serpent. That's why I titled it The Serpent, and some things about Eve in this whole matter. Now, Satan was given access to Adam and Eve. He did not have the power on his own to gain the access, just like he couldn't cause Joe all the drama he caused him without permission. Now, part of the difference here is that Adam and Eve were innocent without sin even being around them. So that's a different case for Job. So his only point of access that he was allowed to them was where? In the garden, yes. But also only at the tree of knowledge of good and evil, where they were told to stay away from, let alone not eat or even touch of it. That's like you being told to not touch poison ivy or eat it. So if you know it is, you stay away from it also. So we know that they were completely warned. They knew what was going on. It's not a secret. Now, stay on board and pay close attention, because we're going to start at Genesis 3:1. It reads, it says, "Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said to the woman, Yea, hath God indeed said, Ye shall not eat of every tree in the garden?" Now, first of all, a lot of things had to have transpired for this first verse to even have had happened. So, first, understand what subtle means. Subtle means delicate or precise, as to be difficult to analyze or describe, or something that's complex and understated, to make you or to make use of clever and indirect methods to achieve something. This is what subtle means. Now, this was a description of the serpent. This is what subtle means. It says the serpent was more subtle. Eve knew, pay attention, Eve knew what a serpent was. It was already in existence, and in fact, Adam named it. In Genesis 20 and verse 2, it says he named all the animals. So, first, it's obvious that Eve, in some point, in some way, was separated from Adam, whether she strayed away from him on her own or what have you, but she has separated herself from Adam, and she got too close in the area where the tree was and in range to have communication with Satan. Now remember, Satan only had access to them at the tree. The Father did not allow Satan to just roam freely about his garden. He gave them access at the tree. That's why he commanded Adam and Eve to stay away from the tree. That was their point of testing. If they stayed away from there, that showed their obedience. We understand and know that if Satan had free rein to just harass them day in, day out, every day, all over the place, he would have. So the Father restricted him and restricted his access to them in the garden at the tree. That's why he was at the tree when Eve got there, or he would have bothered them way before then. Now, we know that Satan is a created being or an angel. So what was so intriguing about an everyday serpent that drew Eve to it? See, she knew what a serpent was because it was one of the animals that the Father created that roamed about freely as all the rest of the animals. So there was nothing extraordinary about it that should have drawn her attention to it to get her near the tree, but there was. So I'm going to point that out. Through the power of the enemy, Satan, it spoke. Think about it. That's what got her. It spoke. Now, the serpent was an animal, but this one spoke. And not only did it speak, Satan used his subtle characteristics to charm Eve. She got caught up. Ladies, have you ever been caught up by a smooth-talking, handsome man? See, this is where it all first started, so none of y'all are alone. The first woman fell for this subtleness, this smooth-talking serpent. And she got caught up, and then she fell into sin. So understand where that came from. Now, the serpent, as I stated, already existed, and we know that Satan used it as a medium. That's what he did. Through his powers, his abilities, he used the serpent as a medium. But the question is, what did the serpent look like? See, first of all, we tend to go straight to this thought. But I say, consider that the serpent could be this, whether you believe it or not. Consider this. Now, your question may be, or a question may be, why would I go off on this tangent or this notion of what some would consider ridiculousness to set myself up for wisecracks, criticism, or whatever? And before you do that, indulge me for a second. The serpent already existed and was nothing new to Adam or Eve. Already established that it was one of the beasts, one of the animals, one of the things that were already created. It did, scriptures nowhere says that they were surprised to see this new creature, so it was already there. Now, this one garnered her attention because it spoke, first of all. Now, obviously, she wasn't surprised at how it looked, so she already knew what a serpent looked like. In 1 Timothy 2:14, it reads, it says, "And Adam was not deceived, but the woman was deceived and was in transgression." Now, keep in mind that Adam was not deceived by the serpent, but he was deceived by his wife through her transgression. See, she became a powerful medium after she sinned. So keep this in thought, as always, in your own household. Someone in your household in sin can and will influence others in the home. Now, go with me to Revelation 12:9. It reads like this. It says, "And the great dragon," back to the dragon again, "that old serpent called the devil and Satan was cast out, which deceiveth all the world. He was even cast into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him." So, now we see that this verse and many others in scripture refer to Satan as a dragon. When and where did all these images of dragons and flying serpents come from? I don't know. I'm sure I could do the history. But we know that dinosaurs, along with many other animals today, are extinct. Are dragons really merely something of fantasy? Where would all these pictures be created from in someone's mind if they've never seen them? They are probably something that existed. Now, but by the way, go with me to Genesis 3:14 and pay very close attention as I read it. "Then the Lord said to the serpent, because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle and above every beast of the field. Upon thy belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of thy life." Now, my question to you is, did you catch it? Okay, pay attention again. First of all, the Almighty showed no mercy on the serpent as he did Adam and Eve. See, they had an opportunity and did repent of their sin. Now, remember, this was Satan using the serpent, and there was no way that the Father was going to give him a chance in any form to obtain a position in heaven again. That's why he didn't show any mercy to the serpent. Now, the seed of rebellion, as we know, lies within Satan, and he is the father of it until he's destroyed in the end. Now, the serpent met Eve while it was in the tree. Question, how did it get there? Answer, well, one, it either crawled or it flew into the tree. When the Almighty cursed the serpent, according to Genesis 3:14, he said, "Upon thy belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of thy life." Now, why would he curse it to become a belly-crawling creature if it already was? What is a curse? Well, a curse is a solemn utterance intended to invoke a supernatural power to inflict harm or punishment on someone or something. That's what a curse is. It requires power to do something. Now, the Father punished this creature with his supernatural power, changing it from what it was to what it has become. He took away its ability to fly by changing it. Now, we can easily deduce that it was a serpent and not a beast of the field. The only other reasonable modes of travel by animals are what? Flying, crawling, or swimming. We know it wasn't a fish. Now, Genesis 3:4 reads, it says, "Then the serpent said to the woman, ye shall not die at all." Understand that this is Satan's, always keep in mind, this is Satan's most superlative form of deception. And that is what? To cause us not to fear the Almighty's threatenings, his promises, what he says will happen to us. This is his most powerful and smoothest form of deception to get us to believe nonsense like that. See, Adam and Eve did die the death for being disobedient. They were spiritually separated from the Almighty, and they were led into great suffering by the enemy. He used the serpent and caused it to become cursed and changed. Ezekiel 28:17 reads, "Thine heart was lifted up because of thy beauty, and thou hast corrupted thy wisdom by reason of thy brightness. I will cast thee to the ground. I will lay thee before kings that they may behold thee." The word tells us that Satan has been cast down here to the earth, and that those in powerful positions are beholden unto him. The enemy works through individual people, through individuals, through people, and especially those in high places. So, with all that, remember, the serpent had to be something before their father turned it into what we consider a serpent or a snake today. He changed it. He cursed it. He changed it from what it was. And with that, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is Brother Lloyd. I'm out.